Today we're going to take a look at D-Line's safety adjustable cable clips. But I'm out of the cold today, aren't I? Oh, the t-shirt.
Well, this range from D-Line have been around for some time, obviously since the 18th edition, and we obviously started to worry more about premature collapse of cable systems. But what we're going to look at today is how D-Line have expanded the range to cope with the needs of the EV installer and the booming EV installation market. Now, we've recently used these clips on the installation behind us.
Well, you can clearly see there what a beautiful installation these clips give. Shall we take a closer look what comes in the packets?
Yeah, well, here's our new pack that we've got here for the EV installer.
Okay, yeah.
So it includes the clips itself. We've got some fixing screws and even a drill, Gary.
Oh, right, so they provide you with, what, is that a 5mm SDS drill bit in order to drill the holes for the screws? Do the screws themselves need any plugs?
No, they don't, so you can obviously use the screws. Let's just take a closer look at them. So you don't need, yeah, so you can fix these direct to most surfaces, including sort of brick and block work.
And that ties in nicely with the 18th edition and the premature collapse, so no plastic plug to worry about in those, okay?
And what I like, so if we look at the screw in there, so here's the clip.
Yeah.
So you probably remember these from, you know, back in the day, Gary?
I did use the odd buckle clip during my training process to toughen up the skin on my hands, yes.
Yeah, so you basically drop the screw in.
Yeah.
What I like is actually the screw sort of snaps into place.
Right, okay. Oh, yeah.
So that's held in the clip.
Oh, right. I like that. They come in different sizes as well. See, we've got all three sizes here. So we'll just go through them. So the first, the smallest one, what diameter cable size is for that?
10 to 15 millimeter cables.
Okay, and this one?
16 to 21 millimeter cables.
And this one?
And 22 to 26 millimeter
cables. Right, okay. Two different finishes as well. We've got obviously galvanized and then covered in black by the looks of things, and then the plain galvanized as well.
Yeah, well, obviously the black for the EV market, because most of the cables you're probably going to be installing are steel wire armored or the tuff sheath type cables that we featured on a previous video.
Okay, so yeah, they've got the diameter of the cable sorted, and it's ideally suited to those cables we know we're going to be using for EV chargers. I take it we're going to need to show this being used, aren't we, Gordon?
Well, it's time to hand it over to our tame grumbling electrician. Off you go, Gary.
Thank you very much. So select the appropriate D-Line EV cable fixing pack based on the diameter of the cable you're using. It comes already with the 5mm SDS drill bits. That's a really nice touch. Remember, we only need to drill the holes out. There's no need for a plug of any variety. We're going to screw straight into the fabric of the building. I'm going to put a couple of clips in just to show you the process. So we drill these two out, and then it'll be a case of getting those screws. And those screws themselves are 35mm long, and the width of the head is 10.8mm. So find them in the packet. They're in an individual packet within the actual set itself, and it nestles in super tight inside the actual clip itself. Just screw it into the fabric of the building. It'll grip really well. So tighten these up. You can almost see how much it's biting into the actual fabric of the building as I screw it up. So it's nice and tight. Do a couple of these, and then I'm going to introduce my EV Ultra just to show you how you just wrap over the clip in order to give an almost invisible fixing. So fold it round, it's all metallic along with the screw, so we've got no plastic at all. So fold it round, and that is the clips done for demonstration purposes on that EV Ultra cable. Just pull back and see how nice that is. That's almost, like I said, invisible fixings. We've used other fixings on the channel, and the feedback from those was that obviously you're making a bit of a statement with this style of fixing. So I believe the ones we just used look a lot neater. A lot of the cable systems for EV are probably not going to need the premature collapsing element of it, especially if it's attached to the outside of the building or maybe low level inside of the building, Gordon.
Yeah, again, you're right, Gary. It depends on where you're installing. Obviously, our demo installation did behind us tighter underground car parks, but again, not in a residential setting, so not as much of an issue. But yeah, most of that time, EV, booming market, it's going to be at the front of your house. And people have watched probably in our previous videos, I don't like to see cables on the house, and I certainly don't like to underline the fact that I've got an EV charge point with a black cable and some cable clamps.
Yeah, and we saw that, didn't we, when we did our easy EV charging video, and if you haven't seen that, I'll recommend you check it out, that actually the one thing people said to us was them clips were a bit obvious, weren't they?
Yeah, it looked a little bit agricultural, and obviously this is where this clip comes in, so if you, you know, I mean, this is almost invisible.
Right, should I take a closer
look? Yeah, take a closer look at that. You know, that is...
Yeah.
Yeah, it just blends into the cable. So all you're going to see is just, yeah, essentially a nice smooth line of the cable on the house and not making a feature of those cable cleats.
So as well as giving that almost invisible clip, Well, there's another element that we really like as well, Gordon, because it's bridged, is it? It doesn't send it dead flat to the surface. You'll bring hand cam in behind us and have a closer look at this. It's
just
really
have a
good.
Little look there, yes. Obviously, in some installations, if you've got an uneven wall,
yep.
Just that tiny gap behind the cable, a bit like you'd get with a normal sort of space bar saddle on conduit.
So as we come down,
is a good advantage.
And let's just bridge that off there, because obviously we've just come into the actual Easy EV charger there. It was another nice feature, because some of them aren't there on the market, actually go dead flush with the surface, don't they?
Yeah, and that's obviously a challenge when you're going into accessories, or say, as we said, uneven walls.
Yeah. As always, we're interested in your comments. Are you currently fitting a lot of EV chargers and you're strapping cables to the outside of buildings using a different fixing? Or are you using this one from D-Line? What's your feelings on it? Is there anything we've missed out you can add to the comments below to help the community? Is there a top tip that you'd like to give when using these clips? We're always interested in those comments. Please leave them below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.